I wish in the world don't ask me.
I'll never tell.
I left two of you as it
felt,
and now you're in
my way.
I trade my soul for a wish,
pennies
and dime for a kiss, and I wasn't looking for this, but now you're in
my way.
Your skin was talking,
ripped
jeans,
skin was
showing,
hot
tight
wind
was blowing.
Where
you're going,
baby?
Hey, I just met you, and this
is
crazy.
But here's
my
number,
so
call me.
It's hard to look right. Not you,
baby.
But here's
my number,
so
call me.
Hey, I just met
you, and this is
crazy.
But here's
my
number,
so call me.
And all the
other people
try
to chase me.
But here's
my
number,
so
call me.
Good morning, Medway. It's Friday, April 24th, and I'm Richard.
And I'm Marina, and welcome to MTV, live from Medway Auto Shop.
Congratulations goes out to all the junior badminton athletes who competed at TV Raw this week. Mrs. Fiddler would like to thank you for your hard work and dedication throughout the season.
Yesterday, the girls' soccer team played their first league game against Lucas. The girls played a hard-fought match, however, unfortunately lost 2-1. The goal was scored by Maddie Fisher, made by a cross by Connie Gerling.
All girls played well. Special mention goes to the Medway defense, including Brittany Rowe, Brooke Wilson, Maddie Fisher, Kristen Vandenhoevel, and Kenzie Carter. The girls' next game is next Wednesday.
Attention tennis players, come be a part of Medway's tennis team. A brief meeting will be held in room 225 on Monday at 12:15. See you there.
Medway is participating in a digital mentorship program. Here's Jenna with more information.
So what is Digital Mentors?
Our Digital Mentors project is part of Safe Schools, and so what we wanted to do is train some grade 11 and 12 students to teach our grade 8 students how to be more digitally responsible.
What's your goal in going to other schools?
We sort of have like a three-part plan. So the first one is when we talk to the grade 8 students, we want them to first be aware of how much media they're using. So we do a whole activity and they take a look at how many hours they're spending with media. Typically it's over 8 hours. It's between 8 and 10 hours a day they're spending with media, which is a bit of a shock for them to realize that. And that's in comparison to some regular stats where they're saying it's about 30 minutes maybe of physical activity that they're getting in comparison. So we first want to make them aware of that. The second part is we want to make them aware of what some of the possible consequences can be, even legal consequences. You know, there's school consequences and parental consequences and things like that at home, but also what are the legal consequences of acting inappropriately online, especially in a criminal manner. So we address that issue. And then last but not least is having them understand how they can prevent and also deal with digital misuse and abuse.
Thanks, Jenna. Any students still wanting to sign up for the EDUCOST Fishing Derby should go to room 248 following the announcements. All students are welcome to sign up for the May 27th Fishing Derby. And could Maggie Sagrin please go to room 248 after the announcements?
Congratulations to the five athletes who qualified for WASA. Alyssa Warad placed second in girls' singles.
Marissa Johnson and Jordan Pranger claimed second in girls' doubles.
And Lauren Kennedy and Matt Talbot took fourth in mixed doubles. Good luck on Monday, Cowboys.
Attention graduating athletes. You may qualify to receive an athletic Emma upon graduation. You have earned points for athletic participation on teams, assistance with athletic events, and SAA involvement. Pick up an application form and guidance today to see if you have enough points. All forms must be returned to guidance department by May 21st.
This is an announcement to this year's and next year's DE peer supporters. If you are interested in being a peer coach for the Special Olympics this June, you must have your forms to Ms. McDonald ASAP. The deadline is the end of April. See Mrs. McDonald if you have any questions.
If you're interested in attending the Barefoot Walk this year, see Mrs. McDonald in guidance for a permission form. The cost to attend a full day for the event is only $2, but you must raise a minimum of $50 for the cause. Fundraising packages are also available in guidance.
The Barefoot Walk raises awareness and funds for global poverty each and every year. Hundreds of students from around the city come together to make a change. If you want to be a part of this important day, forms are available now.
And I'm taking a fresh ship and job shape.
one that's just filter, one that goes electric, and I'm doing my apprenticeship in electrical construction maintenance.
Hey MTV, I'm Tristen, and Mr. Smith is here today to tell us about OYAP. Word is that there was an OYAP excursion.
So the board sets up these signing nights. So these were at, this one was at Fanshawe College.
Mr. Smith, what are the benefits of signing up for OYAP?
So the students not only get their co-op credits, they actually get signed up through the ministry as an apprentice, and they get the benefits of being an apprentice.
My name's Campbell Tollett. I'm doing my co-op at D Equipment, and I'm getting my apprenticeship at heavy equipment.
My name's Jack Haley. I'm working at Parkside Landscaping. I'm going to do my apprenticeship in horticulture. Are the same that burn crosses.
Some of those that work forces are the same that burn. Back to you, MTV.
Best buddies, if you dropped your pink form for the dance-off to Mrs. Bennett, please pick it up on your way to lunch today for your ticket to get in. See you at the dance.
All grade 12 music students must complete a Music M application by the end of the day. Pick up a form from a music teacher today.
Are you looking for volunteer hours? Bacon Fest needs you. Bacon Fest happens in Lucan on Saturday, July 11th. For more details, see guidance.
Do you live out of area? Do you want to take the bus next year? As I do. If so, pick up a choice of school application and guidance. This year, it is first come, first serve.
Attention graduates, if you are hoping to cross the stage at commencement with your friends, you must have a gown and cap ordered by May 1st. No cap and gown ordered, no crossing the stage for graduation.
This is an important Junior Music Council meeting today at Junior Lunch. Attendance is mandatory as we prepare for the upcoming concert.
Attention graduates, are you planning to attend college or university for agricultural program? If so, you should apply to the Middlesex Junior Farmers Award. There are two awards up for grabs. See guidance for details.
The co-op department has been enlisting students in the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program to gain hours toward their apprenticeship. Tristen reports. The Senior Cornerstone Club will meet today at lunch in room 204. All welcome. Congratulations to all the bands who performed at Kiwanis this week, starting with Jazz Band on Tuesday, continuing with Grade 9 Band on Wednesday, and Junior Band last night. Medway was awarded 3 more gold standings. Great job, everyone. The final Kiwanis performance is today, with the Junior Band playing at Saunders at 4:30. Students should meet in the band room after school to change and board the bus.
There will be a junior boys football meeting today at lunch in room 127.
Camp Kimoki is looking for lifeguards and male camp counselors for the upcoming summer. Camp Kimoki is an overnight camp located in Kamoka for children ages 6 to 15. Applicants must be 16 years of age and lifeguards must have NLS certifications. If interested, visit kimoki.com or see Mr. Manning.
All students with IEPs who would like to write their exams and resource need to come to room 143 as soon as possible to sign up for exams.
Would Maddie Fuster please come to guidance after these announcements?
The badminton teams have had another successful season. Here's Justin and Carson with the story.
Hello Medway students, it's Carson and Justin, we're back with the sports.
This time it's all about badminton.
Whoa man, did you see that?
No, let's go check it out.
Alright.
What? Oh, it's Sam Lund and Kira Kruger, TV Rough Pilots.
Oh, yeah.
I think we might perform something for this season.
We got first at TV Raw as a team, so we did pretty well.
Why did you choose to play badminton?
Well, my brother played when he was younger, and I thought it'd be fun.
Your partner's abilities weigh you down and all this stuff?
I don't think so. Instead of weighing me down, she was lifting me up.
I'm here with Danny Marco and Luke Broussard, first place winners of TV Raw and 7th in WASA. What does badminton mean to you?
Badminton is life.
How has Hiscox mentored you guys up to this moment?
He makes us run a lot in practice, maybe a little too much.
How did the tournament go over for you guys?
So we came first at TV Raw.
Back to you, MTV.
Well, that's all the time we have for today, Medway.
Thanks for tuning into this edition of MTBU and have a great weekend.